me this morning, I'm joined by Rob Waugh from Musgrave Minerals. Rob, good morning.
Good to be here. Thanks, Andrew.
Great. Really appreciate your time, Rob. You've had some positive results back this week from work you've been doing at the Starlight Link-Lode discovery. Just tell us a bit more.
I'd love to tell you a bit more about it. So it's been early days for us. We've had a couple of drilling programs now. The main one we've just recently finished, and we've just got the last holes in for that. So we've had some really strong intercepts, including 42 meters at 5.6. We had another 42 meter intersection that was about 65 meters away from the first one, and that went about 6.8 grams. So some nice high grades there. We also had an intercept of about 6 meters at 55 grams. And another intercepts around the 6 meter mark that are ranging from about 13 grams to 7 grams. So some really nice intercepts within that zone that we now have over a strike of about 100 meters. So that's still open to the west and down dip as well.
What was the idea of this drill program? What was the objective?
So the objective really was to confirm the hypothesis that we had this link lode position in place, which is running parallel to all our previous drilling. So it was slipping between the drill holes. So it was a new idea that was brought forward and to test a couple of things that didn't quite add up in the original drilling. A couple of anomalies that we had in there, and we thought, let's test it and turn the rig around 90 degrees. So that has been very successful for us.
So do you reckon this discovery's got some real potential here?
Oh, absolutely. So we've got 100 meters of strike at the moment. The grade's high. We're getting continuity of intercepts. Still open to the west. It's open down dip, as I mentioned, but it's also open up dip. So we've tested it about shallower. We've tested about 70 meters. So we've still got that zone between there and surface to test as well. We know it doesn't have a surface expression, but it could get easily within 10 or 20 meters of that current surface. So we're looking forward to the shallow drill testing as well as the deeper drill testing.
So what are the immediate plans from here then? Give us a rough time frame of what you're going to be doing.
Yeah, so some of the things that we're doing at the moment, we're waiting for some 1 meter samples, which at the moment we've got composite sampling and a combination of 1 meter samples. So we're waiting for that last lot of samples to come through over the next couple of weeks. And then we'll have a drill rig back out doing shallow RC testing, drilling in between our existing holes, extending it up closer to the surface, drilling a little bit deeper as well, but also extending out to the west where the final hole, the last hole we did on the western end, we shanked the bit. So we effectively lost the bit down the hole, so we couldn't penetrate through. And right in those last few meters, we're just starting to see a little bit more encouragement. We're starting to see the veining coming in and the gold coming in, but that hole couldn't penetrate through to the mineralized zone because of the bit being left in the hole. So we have to redrill that, but that leaves it very open to the western side. So we're looking forward to testing that zone as well. So it's quite a lot of big program coming up, and we're looking forward to it.
And that's coming up in May, is it?
Yeah, that's coming up in May. So at the moment, we're still waiting on a few results, get that program, those results through, and then get the drill rig out in May. But what this will do too is because of the mineralization is relatively close to surface and it's between and around existing mineralization, it will significantly add to the economics of what we already have. So it's an exciting time.
So by the sounds of it, you're not being restricted by some of these limitations in place by the recent outbreak of COVID-19?
Look, the outbreak of COVID-19, it's definitely made us very, very self-aware and conscious. We're being very careful about what we do. We've got new procedures and systems in place to try and combat and minimize contact. We're in quite a remote area, so we do have that as an advantage. But it is definitely on the back of our minds. But we are very conscious of it. We're looking after the health of our employees, their families, our contractors, and our stakeholders. So we're very conscious of that. But at the moment, we are not physically restricted. But obviously, times change and things are adapting pretty quickly in this space.
And Rob, what about the continued strength of the gold price here? That clearly must bode well for you.
Look, it's really good, especially in Aussie dollar terms. You know, the price is at pretty close to record highs for Australian dollar, and we're looking forward to that continuing. I mean, there's definitely enough uncertainty in the market to favour that. Another important thing to note, I guess, for us is really the cash position of the company. So we have roughly around just under $3 million in the bank, a pretty strong cash position to be in going into the current climate. So we're looking forward to doing that drilling program and a strong Aussie gold price going forward.
Good to see you, Rob. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew.